Good morning, cyber traders. Welcome on this what we got Monday going on. We only got two more days left going on for the end of this month. How's everybody doing? Good to see you, Lawrence. Good to see you. Good morning to you, Mark. Good to see you, Lita, Ben, Lane, Tim, Grant. Good to see you guys. Welcome back on to this lovely Monday. Hopefully everybody had a great weekend. Kind of rainy here in New York. Like I said, April showers bring May flowers. Hopefully it's not like last year. But listen, a lot of stuff going on this week, everybody. A lot of big news that's coming out. Just want to kind of go over a couple of things with you. We're going to talk about what's moving. Remember, today is Monday. First of all, I'd like to welcome all our new members here that are joining us on their Monday. We always have new members that start on Monday. Guys, just look, listen, and learn. Just be very careful because there's definitely, a lot you're going to learn when it comes to trading. Some things you're going to be shocked that says, my God, I wish I knew this when I first got started. But anyway, just go over a couple of things that we got going on. There's a lot of news that's going to be happening this week. And, a lot of big earnings. I think they said this is actually going to be the biggest week in earnings. So when it comes to trading, I mean, there's so much news that's coming out. There's going to be trade talks. I just took a whole couple of things over here. What do we got going? Boeing shares are Bo a Boeing shareholder meetings going on today. You got earnings coming out. You got Apple. You got McDonald's, GE. You got Jesus, Yum Brands, CVS, Under Armour, Kellogg's. What else you got? Weight Watchers. That was a fun stock to eat. I mean, the list of Spotify, Lowe's going on today. You could just the list is going on. So this is almost the biggest week when it comes to earnings. So does that make it a very exciting week? You also have a couple of big news that are coming out. Obviously, you got the AG Barr is going to be testifying this week. On Thursday, that's going to be fun. April job reports come on Friday. I always say that on Friday. What else you got going on? Anything that looks interesting here? You got the House a hearing on Medicare for all. On Tuesday, trade talks at Beijing. So there's a lot of good stuff that's going on. So it's going to be a very, very exciting part of trading. All right, now, and then most important, it's exactly right, guys. This is starting tomorrow. Phase three is going to be starting. So with phase three courses, you're going to be trading live with me. So if you are a gold, diamond, platinum student, you're going to go out there and take everything you learned from last week, from phase one and phase two. We're going to put it to the test and see how it works. Now remember, the phase three part of the lesson is not about just making money. Remember, our job here at Cyber Training University and you being part of this family is not about making money. It's about controlling losses. The winners take care of themselves. It's the losers that everyone has a problem with. And that's why you're in class. Obviously we do well in our classes, and but the most part of it is you always learn by how to control those big losses. So don't ever forget that. That's the fun part of it. All right, so you got that list up there, and then you got what's going on in regarding our upcoming events. Now let's go to the platform and let's see what's going on regarding about some moves. But let's talk about some of the stocks that we traded last week. First of all, let me bring that Mattel trade. That stock was a great short. You could see how that stock right at the gate went from about 1360 all the way down to about 12 bucks. Not a huge winner, but the only thing I didn't like about it really didn't make the real good short until like 12 o'clock, which you pretty much know that a lot of us day traders, we really don't trade in the middle of the day. It's pretty much we're done when it comes around that time. So, if you're around it, I had a couple of shakes here and there, but overall, it was pretty slow and steady. JMAI was another nice little pop right there. Let me just fix this chart right here because my time frame is not looking too well. Okay, so that one had a really good push yesterday on Friday, and then she had a nice little push, came down right around that 330. Thought it was going to do a little bit better than that, but she's moving pretty nicely in here. So listen, this one's going back on the watch list. So not only you can see she's an IPO, she came out and she took a little bit of a hit. Like anything else, sometimes they run them up a little too fast. 20 all the way to 450, came right back down. Pretty volatile, though. Be very careful. Look at that spread. You've got to be careful of that spread right there. And then J Nugget was obviously a great play all day. JNUG. We're not really big fans of trading ETFs. But there are time to time when, they do come in play, and Friday was one of them. So that one was pretty good also. All right. So what's going on this morning? Okay, what are we trading? Listen, couple of stocks, not a lot. It's your typical Monday. We know when we deal on Mondays, there's not a lot of news over the weekend. So there are a couple of things that are moving, and that's one of the things that a lot of you new traders always learn here is that every day, there's certain days that are better than others. Monday mornings are usually not the greatest, probably until the market opens up. But there are a couple of things that are moving. We're going to start off with INNT, that one for some of you that we hear in pre-market. Have been watching it. Let me bring it up. She gapped up humongous right here. You can see that thing just really took off, but she's backing off all of a sudden. So now I'm like, I'm contemplating maybe taking off my watch list. She's up 12%, but she was up about 30, 40%. So I don't know what, I guess whatever that news was that gapped it up, obviously he's not looking too well. But I'll put it on the watch list. Stock trade over 3.8 million shares already in pre-market. You got great iceberg orders on that matrix. We'll keep a close eye on that one. The MBRX, another one we were watching this pre-market. This one, we've all remembered, we just traded it not too long ago, a couple of days ago, went from $1 to $3. Great mover. For all the YouTube and Twitter, and everyone's going to watch this video later. People always look at it. They're like, I thought these stocks really don't move. Oh, really? How did that work out for us? Worked out pretty damn well. Great volume, 1 million shares. She's got some resistance levels here at $1.60. She's got a good spread. This stock could listen, when it started getting all volatile, it was no level one stock, but as of right now, it is level one, so it looks pretty good. One good stock that I told you that I've been trading as a swing trade that's doing pretty well is Pinterest. Pinterest, I think the smartest thing they did with Pinterest is they didn't open it up like they did with what was it? Lyft. So it's going up nice, slow, and steady. So that stock's been, it's not really a day trade. It's been more of a swing trade. She's breaking higher highs. That one's doing pretty well. So that's on the Fausto list. PRPO is another one that popped up on my radar. A lot of you just saw this thing just take off and she just came right back down. Now, remember what I said in pre-market when we were looking at the stock? I says, guys, be very careful. Stock's got a very big spread. Okay. And the stock is pretty damn volatile. So, I know some of you guys were watching it, were trading it. You got that little rally, but then she did that little shake over here in pre-market when she went from 5 to 8. I know some of you guys hit it around 6, got out around 7. Just hopefully, remember what I always tell you, take the money and run all the time. A blast from the past. Momo, remember this stock? Momo, we've traded the stock so many times. Go back to your journals. Remember, the big thing we always tell you, focus and review and take good notes on your day trades because you're going to trade these stocks again. Maybe not tomorrow, maybe not next week, not month, next month. But if you had a good trade in that position and you know how it trades, it's always nice to have a little head start to go back and have a nice little track record because you are going to trade these stocks. Anyway, stocks gap down and she's been a nice little bounce in the pre-market, 33.50 to 34.50, 53 now. Great mover. Not the greatest orders out there though. So you got to be, the stock is definitely way above a over a level one category. And then the JMIA is not what I found this morning. This stock, like I said, piggybacking off from the day before, I'm throwing that back on the watch list. Got my PRPO matrix fixed. Okay, well, it was broken for you, Ken. All right, but I think that's about it. It's not a huge list, which is perfectly normal. It's a Monday, so we have to wait for the market to open up. But other than that, I really don't see anything else out there. Anything I'm missing? I did not call out. Ben says already up 45 cents on already on Momo. Let's give him a round of applause. Way to go. All right. It's always nice to start and be positive in pre-market, isn't it? Isn't it great? It's always nice to have a little bit of a profit. All right, guys. So listen, we'll see you back here at 2:30 for the afternoon meeting. So now we're going to do for all you new members, we go into silence. All the traders, just please keep in mind, this is not a teaching room. This is a trading room. And make sure you talk to your education advisor so he can tell you a little bit about the lessons, about what you're going to learn here in the Cyber Group room. And then don't forget, for all the students of Cyber Trading University, phase three starts tomorrow morning. All right, guys. So I'll see you all then. In the meantime, good luck today. And we'll see you back at 2:30 for the afternoon meeting.